I am going to one of the most important points or one of the most examination oriented area under this gratuity. We are saying completed year of service. We are saying completed year of service. Sir, what is meant by completed year of service? Completed year of service means continuous service for a period of 1 year. But here he is defining what is meant by completed year of service. Continuous service for a period of 1 year. Next doubt arises. What is meant by continuous service? This is a very, very important area under the set. Continuous service. When can you say that the employee is in continuous service? See, I will ask you a question. I was working with A Limited. So when I was going in bike, what happened? I fell down. Met with an accident. For 3 months I did not go to the office. Getting my point? Yes, from April to June I did not go to office. Now will you call this as a continuous service? Yes, now a doubt arises, yes or not? Yes, 3 months I was not there at the office. Whether it is a continuous service or it is not a continuous service. Getting my point? Yes, all those confusions are clarified by this section. So this section says what is to be regarded as continuous service and what is not to be regarded as continuous service. To say whether there is a continuous service or not, Fasil needs to undertake 2 tests. Test number 1, test number 2. See, Fasil will always try to clear test number 1. But in case if an employee is not able to clear test number 1, then test number 2. So if he satisfies either test number 1 or you can say that this person is a continuous service. Test number 1 is called as uninterrupted service. If Fasil is continuing in the company, if he is continuing in the office without any interruptions, you will call it as an uninterrupted service. Respond, Baba. Certain interruptions shall be treated as uninterrupted service. Though there are certain interruptions, they shall be regarded as uninterrupted service. See, where any interruption that is taking place as a result of sickness, where any interruption is taking place as a result of sickness or as a result of accident, marriage na accident an kekada, or as a result of accident or as a result of leave with wages or as a result of absence without break in service or as a result of absence without break in service or as a result of layoff or as a result of lockout or as a result of strike or as a result of any other cessation not because of the fault of the employee, not because of the fault of employee. See, closely follow. Normally what is the understanding? Uninterrupted service means except some days he should have come and worked in the organization, then only you can call it as an uninterrupted service. We try to draw some inference, correct? Now what the legislature is saying, see, even if a service is going to get interrupted because of sickness, 2 months typhoid, we will put it. Now what happens? Interrupted service or uninterrupted service? Then accident, as I told you, when I was working with A Limited, I fell down. Come on, friend. Yes, 3 months I did not go to office. This is what? Interrupted service or uninterrupted service? Interruption, but still it shall be regarded as an? Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Then I told you, leave with wages. You work for 300, sir, you work for 270 days, I will give you salary for? Is it interrupted service or uninterrupted service? Uninterrupted service. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
In the absence without break in service, I will come. Lay off. Should I explain what is lay off? Should I explain what is lockout? What is lockout? Employer closes it down, it is called as lockout. Appa, why should I not call it as layoff? Full lock close banana, shut down. Problems between employee and employer. I'll tell you like this. There is some dispute between employer and employee says, I will not work now, it is called a strike. Come on, yeah.
Yes,
employer says, until you say yes, I will not open the factory now, that is called as?
Yes,
layoff, lockout, strike, everything you should understand it in a proper manner. Layoff in a, there is no dispute between the employer and?
Employer.
But still, employer is not having work to give, thereby the employer is saying, stay out of the employment for next 2 months, this is called as? Sorry. Suppose there is some dispute between the employer and employee. The employer says I can pay bonus of only 15%. Employees are saying pay bonus of 20%. Some dispute is there between the employer and the employee. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Now when there is a dispute between the employer and the employee, employees are saying, no, no, until you accept our request or until you accept our the request which was placed by us, we will not come to work. Abdina Enartho? That is called as strike. If the employer is saying, come on, yeah. Employer is saying, come on, until you keep quiet or until you accept my request, I will not open the factory now. This is called as? Are you all following? Very simple, yeah. If you students are going, saying that no, no, we don't want class at this time. Abdin sonna adukku per enna?
Strike.
If we faculties are getting tensed because you are so restlessness, because of your restlessness, we are tensed and we are walking away, na, that is called as? Puriyadha
sir?
Next. Absence without break in service. Absence without break in service. Little bit difficult to closely follow. See what happened. There was one of my relatives. The relative, younger age lende, little bit, what to say, insane only, eccentric fellow. He will not stick on to his decisions, immediately he will change his decisions. So, somehow with great difficulty he cleared some course, graduation. Then he went and joined in a job. After some 2 years of work over there, some personal problem for him, what he did? 3 months ago, he was not at all available anywhere. We were searching him in and out, he was not available. Enna pantana? He went to Himalayas. During this 3 months period, he went to Himalayas. After the 3 months period, again he came back. Employer also, what he did? Okay, henceforth don't listen. He took him into employment. Come on, friend.
Yes, sir.
The sickness, huh?
No.
Accident, huh?
No.
Leave with wages, huh?
No.
Come on, yeah.
Yes,
now what happens? There is an absence without any break in service. Employer says, okay, come back into the employment. I am happy to take you back into the employment. This is an absence without break in service. Come on, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Suppose if he is coming after 6 months, employer says, I will take you into employment, but this I will consider it as a fresh employment. I will take you into employment, but this I will consider it as a
fresh
employment. Abdina, this is a
break-in
service. Come on, yeah.
Yes,
so where there is absenteeism but there is no break-in service, now it shall still be regarded as an uninterrupted service. Are you all with me?
Yes,
3 months Himalayas pona na?
Yes,
3 months he went to Himalayas. Sir.
Yes, sir.
During that period he did not serve at the office, correct?
Yes, sir.
Still will he be eligible for gratuity for that year?
Yes,
he will be eligible for gratuity for that year?
Yes,
yes. Because it is to be regarded as an uninterrupted service.
Yes,
what is meant by continuous service? To decide whether an employee is in continuous service or not, we should see whether there is a break-in service or there is no break-in service, or whether there is an uninterrupted service or there is no uninterrupted service. Test 1 speaks about uninterrupted service. Come on.
Yes,
so if a person he fails in test 1, then what you can do? If a person fails in test 1, then what you can do? You can move to test 2. If a person fails in test 2 also, then he is not eligible for gratuity for that year. Okay. What is meant by uninterrupted service? Uninterrupted service means without any interruption. But under some circumstances, even if there is any interruption, it shall be regarded as an test number 2 is number of working days. Test number 2 is number of working days. Closely follow. Inga, I classify the establishment into 3. Where the establishment is a mine, or where the establishment is any establishment which is working below the ground level, or where there is an establishment which works for lesser than 6 days a week, others. Mine, below ground level, or where there is an establishment which works for lesser than 6 days a week, others. Here, he should have worked for 190 days. Here, he should have worked for 190 days. Here, he should have worked for 240 days. Now, in computing this working days, in certain days absence shall be treated as deemed presence. In certain days absence shall be treated as deemed presence. Can you tell me what could be those circumstances? Same things. Same as POBA, except one difference. In a maternity leave not exceeding 12 weeks. Maternity leave shall not exceed 12. Did you see under Payment of Bonus Act, Act did not place any restriction on the maximum number of maternity leave days that can be given. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Here the Act is placing a restriction that the maternity leave shall not exceed 12 months in the don't try. Adukula next maternity leave vandrom. Now what is that we should do? Two tests we should see to decide whether an employee has rendered continuous service or not. We should perform two tests. What are the two tests that should be performed? One is the test number 1, the other is the test number 2. Come on, friend.
Yes, sir.
Once we get through this area, all the other areas will be simple, very, very simple. So test number 1 should be there, test number 2 should be there. Test number 1 speaks about what? Uninterrupted service. Test number 2 speaks about what? Number of working days. So test number 1, uninterrupted service. What is meant by uninterrupted service? No interruption in the service, correct?
Yes, sir.
But certain days, though there is any interruption in service, it shall be regarded as an? Certain days, though there is an interruption in service, it shall be regarded as? Can you tell me what are all those days? Sickness, accident, leave with wages, absence without break in service, layoff, lockout, strike, any other cessation not being the fault of the employer. Excellent. Now, இது அப்படியே பேர் பேரா பாரியா சிக்னஸ் ஆக்சிடென்ட் ஒன் கேட்டகரி வி கேன் குரூப் கமான் யா லீவ் ஆப்சன்ஸ் லாக் அவுட் ஸ்ட்ரைக் என்னயா லே ஆஃப் ஆர் எனி அதர் திங் நாட் பீங் தி ஃபால்ட் ஆஃப் தி எம்ப்ளாயி எவ்ரிவே எங்க ஒருத்தர் சொல்லிட்டு பார்க்கலாம் அன்இன்டரப்டட் சர்வீஸ் வேற பர்சன் ஹஸ் நாட் ஹஸ் ரெண்டர்ட் சர்வீஸ் வித்வுட் எனி இன்டரப்ஷன் தென் யூ வில் ஹீ இஸ் எலிஜிபிள் ஃபார் கிராஜுவிட்டி ஃபார் தட் இயர் எஸ் ஆர் நாட் சர்டன் டேஸ் தோ தர் இஸ் அன் இன்டரப்ஷன் இட் ஷால் பி ரிகார்டட் அஸ் அன் அன்இன்டரப்டட் சர்வீஸ் கேன் யூ டெல் மீ வாட் ஆர் ஆல் தோஸ் டேஸ் சிக்னஸ் ஆக்சிடென்ட் தென் லீவ் வித் வேஜஸ் ஆப்சன்ஸ் வித்வுட் பிரேக் இன் சர்வீஸ் கரெக்டா நெக்ஸ்ட் lockout strike அதாவது if the strike is done by the employer na you call it as a come on yeah if it is done by the employees na you call it as a strike அதுக்கு அப்புறம் என்ன lay off or any other cessation not being the fault of the employer are you all following that
yes sir
everybody
yes sir
you know what is leave and what is absence leave na it is with permission absence right is without permission and that next if the employee is failing in test number 1 please cooperate this area alone if the employee is failing in test number 1 next what should be done test number 2 test number 2 is nothing but the test on the basis of number of
working days
now what this provision says where if the employee is working in a mine or below ground level how many days you should have worked sir interruption is there in my service sir there is an interruption in my service but still you will be eligible for gratuity if you have worked for at least 190 days are you all with me
yes, sir
or where there is an establishment which is working for lesser than 6 days a week software company mar which works only for 5 days a week now under those establishments how many days they should have worked
190
in all the other establishment that is an establishment which is working for 6 days or 7 days a week na then 240 Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Now there is a problem. Enna problem? Can I apply this to a seasonal establishment employee?
No.
Seasonal establishment employee, 190 days you should have worked. Season order size may not be 190 days, sir. We may have 6-month season or we may not have 6-month season. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Appa seasonal establishment employee, can we apply these same provisions? No, it will not be operative for a seasonal establishment employee. So, for seasonal establishment employee, we are having a different mechanism. What is the different mechanism? Test number 1 remains the same. Enna?
Yes,
test number 1 remains the same. Test number 2 alone will undergo a change. What is the change in test number 2? Instead of computing the number of working days, you will see whether he has worked for at least 75% of the number of days for which the season was in operation. Enna? 75% of the number of days for which the season was in
operation.
Are you all getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Everybody?
Yes, sir.
Enga solli for a seasonal establishment employee, how will you make the computation? No, first what you will say? For a seasonal establishment employee also, test 1 will also be there, test 2 will also be there. Test number 1 enna? Uninterrupted service. Test 2 enna? If he has worked for 75% of the number of days, for which the season was in operation. Where an employee has worked for 30 years and 8 months, what he will do? 30 years and 8 months. Now we will straight away put it as? But now, 30 years he has worked. After that, not even one day he came to the job. But still, officially, the employment closes only after a period of 8 months. Come on, friends.
Yes, sir.
Suppose a person is due to retire on 31st August 2014. Appada, his employment comes to an end. But after 31st December, he never came to the office. He never came to the office. But now the issue is, whether should we pay him gratuity for 30 years or should we pay gratuity for 31 years? 30 years or 31 years? For this we should see if this person is in continuous service for a period of 6 months. If the person is in continuous period for the period of 6 months, then it can be rounded up to 1. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
Whether a person is in continuous period of 6 months, and we should see if he is in continuous period for this period of 6 months, then it can be rounded up to 1. How it can be checked, sir, whether he is in continuous service or not? Same test we will make. Same test you will make. In test number 1 is uninterrupted service. Test number 2 is number of working days. In the number of working days, divide everything by 2. Number of working days, divide everything by 2. Up and off. Where an employee has worked for 31 years and 6 months or more. Now what you should do? For each year you should check whether he has been in uninterrupted service. For the broken period of 6 months and above, you should check whether he has been in uninterrupted service or he has satisfied the number of working days. Are you all following?
Yes, sir.
31 years and 8 months, irka, sir.
Yes, sir.
Ah, sorry. 30 years and 8 months, irka.
Yes, sir.
Now, this person, he should have worked for each of these 30 years, correct?
Yes, sir.
And he should have also worked for this 8 months period, correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Only if he has rendered continuous service for a period of 6 months or more, it can be rounded up to? So, now we should see whether he is in continuous service for a period of 6 months or more, correct?
Yes, sir.
How to find out whether he is in continuous service for a period of 6 months or more? Very simple, uninterrupted service or number of working days. Uninterrupted service normally you apply number of working days, divide the number of working days by?
2. Yes, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Appa eppadi paaru. 30 years he has worked, 8 months is the broken period. Now what you should see? For each of those 30 years, you should see whether he has rendered uninterrupted service or 190, 190 or 240 days. You should see. Respond, friends.
Yes, sir.
For this broken period of 8 months, for this broken period of 8 months, you should see whether he was in uninterrupted service or he was for 95 days, 95 days or 120 days. Now he will become eligible for 31 years.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Everybody.
Yes, sir.
Honestly.
Yes, sir.
Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Now, if an employee has worked for 30 years and 4 months, what will you see? Each of those 30 years, say, whether he has rendered service, and if you see, that is sufficient, correct?
Yes, sir.
But where an employee has rendered service for 30 years and 9 months, what you should see? For each of those years, whether he has rendered uninterrupted service or 190, 190, 214, you should check. And for the broken period of 9 months, you should check whether he has worked for uninterrupted service or 95, 95 and 120. Continuous service. For a period of 6 months. When can you say that an employee is in continuous service for a period of 6 months? Test number 1 to be applied or test number 2 to be applied? Test number 1 is uninterrupted service. Test number 1 is uninterrupted service. Test number 2 is number of working days. What is that number of working days? Mine are the 95 days. Establishment working for less than 6 days a week are the it is less than 6 days a week and again it is 95 days. Others it should be 120 days. Here also certain absence is equal to deemed presence. Here also certain absence shall be regarded as deemed presence. What is the quantum of gratuity? How to compute the gratuity? Everybody close your notebooks, close your notebooks, close your notebooks. How to compute this? Last drawn salary into 15 by 26 into completed year of service or part thereof in excess of. This is how you will compute gratuity, correct?
Yes, sir.
This computed amount shall not exceed.
10 lakhs.
This computed amount shall not exceed.
10 lakhs.
If he is going to be a piece rated employee, what will he do? Instead of last drawn salary, I will take the average of last 3 months salary. If he is going to be a disabled employee, what will he do? Two computation I will do. One is the computation before disablement. One is the computation after disablement. Before disablement, what salary he will take? On the date of disablement, what salary here and that salary will take? Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
After disablement, what I will take? Last drawn salary I will take. Getting my point, friend?
Yes, sir.
If he is going to be a seasonal establishment employee, what will you do? You will ask a question. You will ask a question. What question you will ask? Whether he worked throughout the year or he worked only for season. If he had worked throughout the year, what will happen? Normal computation. If he has worked only during seasons, what will happen?
Last
drawn salary into 7 by 26 into number of
seasons.
Here we are saying completed year of service or part thereof in excess of 6 months, correct?
Yes, sir.
If an employee has worked for 28 years and 6 months, eligible for 28 years gratuity at 29 years, sir? He is eligible only for 28 years gratuity. Are you all with me, friends?
Yes, sir.
Next, you are saying completed year of service. Completed year of service. What is meant by completed year of service? Completed year of continuous service for a period of 1 year. If I have rendered continuous service for a period of 1 year, that is regarded as one completed year of service. For that year, I am eligible for gratuity. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Like this, how many continuous year of service I have rendered, I will take that many things and for that many years I will pay you.
Yes,
following a friend.
Yes, sir.
Then enough, how to understand whether a person is in continuous service or not? How many tests he will perform?
Two tests
he will perform. Both the tests are to be performed?
No.
If test 1, first what you will perform? Test 1. If test 1 is not satisfying, then test 2. Test 2 is also not satisfying, na? He is not eligible for gratuity for that year. 1974 le employed, 2014 le retiring. In between in the year 1987, come on friends,
yes,
test 1, test 2 not satisfied. He is not eligible for all these years gratuity. Yeah?
No.
And the 1987 alone he is not eligible for gratuity. Are you all getting this point?
Yes, sir.
Sir, enough, tell me friends, how to test this continuous service, test 1 or test 2? Test 1 speaks about what? Uninterrupted service, which means even for 1 day there should be no interruption in the service, correct?
Yes, sir.
But certain interruptions shall be deemed to be uninterrupted service. Can you tell me what are all those interruptions?
Sickness,
accident, leave with wages, absence without break in service, apron, layoff, strike or lockout strike. Lay off, any other cessation in the employment without any fault of the employee. Are you all thorough with this?
Yes, sir.
Suppose I am not satisfying test number 1, am I not eligible for gratuity of that year?
No.
I am still eligible for gratuity if I satisfy test number
2.
Test number 2 is nothing but the number of working days. How many days I should have worked? If it is going to be a mine, then I should have worked for? If it is going to be an establishment which was for lesser than 6 months or 6 days a week, na? If it is going to be any other establishment, na? Seasonal establishment employee, ki, whether 190, 190, 240, whether it will hold good.
No.
So, thereby for a seasonal establishment employee, I will do test 1 and test 2. Are you all with me?
Yes, sir.
Test 1 if he fails, then he'll come to test 2. Here test 2 is what? 75% of the number of days for which the season was in operation. 4 months is the season time frame. This person should have worked at least for a period of
3 months.
Are you all following that?
Yes, sir.
Then, this completed year of service for the whole period, that is for a whole complete year of service, I can find out whether he is in continuous service or not. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
That broken period of 7 months, 8 months, 9 months and all will come, no?
Yes, sir.
Whether during those periods, whether he was in continuous service or not, how to test that? For that also we are having test 2, test number 1 uninterrupted service, test number 2 is number of days. Here number of days are you divided by
2.
95, 95,
120.